charges, sir, I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother, married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastard, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
What's your name? Billock? Kenmore? Conway?
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumour going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, got to make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. And back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
This is a warning!
Ah!
Quiet!
Oi!
This is a warning!
Oi!
Quiet,
water.
You!
Ah!
Oi!
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you.
Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
He's dead in me sight!
Aye, stop. Ah, the bastard's running.
You!
You weren't much of a friend, Jack Rackham, nor an able sailor, neither. But you were strange and lively. You made me laugh more than once. That's enough to make me sorry for seeing you like this. I hope you found a lasting peace, down there among the dead.
Stop, I want to talk to you. Get the intruder!
Oh.
Oh.
I'll catch you and thump you into next week.
Stop there!
Discovered and brought here. Didn't hear what happened after, though.
Don't play!
That's the luck you make.
I wish we'd parted as friends.
Me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh!
Oh! Oh! I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent.
Can you walk?
Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
I can't.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Stop. Stop, please.
I ain't leaving you, damn it. Lift your arm.
It's no good.
You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, can we? I will.
What's happened to Mary? What's wrong?
Is she gone?
Oh, no.
Oh, God! Oh!
What will you do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward Kenway.
bottle.
I'd see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in 1/5 the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll sweeten you, maggot. I'll cut you down! Calm, little puppy. And slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness.
Robert!
Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Here's a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Idea that he too was just as strong and capable. So, with a great flapping and rustling of feathers, the jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the coat of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal. His strength were not up to the task. Even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram hardly noticed. Nearby, just across the field, the shepherd saw the fluttering bird and was quite amused. Running up, he captured the jackdaw and clipped its beak.
No more than 2 years! You promised me!
You left! When I needed you the most!
But you had me! What keeps you wondering? Do I not make you happy?
I'm so close, Caroline! Please! Just let me do this!
Is everything you do out of spite, Edward?
It's not spite! That's driving me, Mary! It's courage!
Courage? For what, man? There's no one left in your life to care!
God damn you all! I can handle this!
Lout! Always tearing down when you could be building things up, or building yourself up if nothing else!
Just leave me be!
Change course, Edward! Change your bloody course before it's too late!
Captain Kenway! You look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy.
After leaving me with Robert, I shall have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving?
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Ade, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.